A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st December, Sunday. On the front page you have, "We'll be frank with Delhi to avoid misunderstandings," says Gotabaya. So we know Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapakse is on a visit to India. This is his first visit after being sworn in as president. And here he, in his statements, he's saying that India and other countries must invest more in Sri Lanka if they want to provide an alternative to Chinese investment. Even in yesterday's newspaper, we saw India has initiated a line of credit further for Sri Lanka too. So we are taking keen interest in Sri Lanka for strategic strategic perspective, because it is an Indian Ocean country, and the important sea routes pass through this region. Then below you have 65% turnout in first phase of Jharkhand Assembly elections. So Jharkhand Assembly elections have taken place. So we'll see the results of these two. And this is regarding Maharashtra. We have already known now that Uddhav Thackeray has formed his government along with Congress and NCP. And this is regarding this gang rape case of Hyderabad, in which a veterinary doctor was gang raped by truck drivers in Hyderabad. So this has prompted Delhi police to reinforce women's safety. And fresh instructions have been issued to respond at once to distress calls. And here you have Northeast to be shielded from citizenship law impact. So here it is Amit Shah with leaders from Northeastern states who have said that new citizens will not be allowed to settle in the region. And we have seen that the citizenship amendment bill has major opposition from Northeastern states. So now an exemption here is being provided for these states here. So, and also a plan is there for a nationwide NRC as Home Minister Amit Shah has already announced. On page 5 you have, better wages make MP tribals shift base. So agricultural laborers from Madhya Pradesh migrate to Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh every season because of better pay. So here this is a coverage on this. On page 8 you have, probe sought into sabotage of Vande Bharat Express. So this is the new indigenously developed train called Vande Bharat or Train 18. So here there is a controversy going on over halting of production of Train 18 coaches at Integral Coach Factory in Chennai. So now top railway official has written to Railway Board Chairman demanding an inquiry into the sabotage of Vande Bharat Express project. So though it had been acclaimed that it has been completed in record time and indigenous development of these trains, indigenous production of these trains would take place, but now it is seen that Vande Bharat Express has been stalled and questions are being raised by the railway officials themselves. And below you have PSLV gearing up for its 50th flight. So in nearly 3 decades, it has launched more than 45 Indian payloads. And this will be the 50th flight of ISRO's PSLV. This is the QL variant of PSLV, which will be employed with 4 strap-on boosters. So you can see this will be PSLV C-37. The C-37 mission has the credit of placing 104 satellites in orbit. And now this will be the 50th PSLV launch, which will be having on board 10 satellites, including India's RESAT-2BRI and 9 small satellites from abroad. So this is the detail given here. You can see it will be PSLV C-48 mission, which is just scheduled for December 11. So earlier we have seen how CartoSat 3 has been launched by PSLV. So now this is the 50th flight which will take place. On page 9 you have, antibiotic prescription rate high in private sector. So India is considered to be one of the top users of antibiotics according to this report. You can see it shows a large number of antibiotic prescriptions being given, and the rate of antibiotic prescriptions quite high in private sector in India. And here you have, report on forest soon. So this is an exercise to ascertain increase or decrease in cover. So Environment Ministry is likely to release an update on state of forests in India in December. On page 10, you have recent Supreme Court verdicts rein in constitutional authorities. So this is regarding Supreme Court verdicts in November, like the one on the political crisis in Maharashtra and in Karnataka. So this has sent strong messages to high constitutional authorities. In both cases, it was the governor's role which was in question. So it has asked high constitutional authorities like the governor, who shed their neutrality in favor of party politics in states, that they should be neutral and objective. So these are landmark judgments of the Supreme Court in a sense. And below you have India, Japan call upon Pakistan to act on terror. So India and Japan had the inaugural 2+2 dialogue summit, in which Indian of External Affairs Minister and Defense Minister along with their Japanese counterparts had discussions, and it was a statement was given that Pakistan should comply with commitments to FATF, Financial Action Task Force, and act on terror. Financial Action Task Force is a multilateral organization to act against terror funding and money laundering. On international page, you have here you can see these are protests going on in Chile. An activist is using a slingshot during a protest against gender violence and patriarchy. So these are protests against social and economic equality taking place in the South American country, Chile. And below you have climate protesters occupy German coal mines. So they have said that government is not doing enough to phase out fossil fuels, and they have occupied German coal mines in Germany here. Then on business page, you have wettest monsoon in 25 years could lift 2020 wheat output. So higher government procurement and subsidy for exports are also needed to ensure that wheat production sees a record jump. So the coverage on that. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage. So there are important issues over the week covered in this. So first one is regarding Maharashtra. You can see fractured verdicts and governor's role. So on the issue of governor's role in Maharashtra, this is a coverage which talks about Sarkaria Commission. So Sarkaria Commission on Center-State Relations had given its recommendations for the governor and his role too. So this article talks of what do Sarkaria Commission recommendations say? What has the Supreme Court ruled on this issue? So there's a complete coverage on this. And this is e-toll for the roads. So this is regarding FASTag. We have discussed this too. They are radio frequency identification enabled tags, which are there as such on the windshields of the vehicles. And you can go through tolls without stopping. The connectivity is there, and then you are through Wi-Fi, and then you can directly have the amount deducted from your linked account. So this has been made mandatory on national highways. It was actually to be implemented from today, 1st December, but now it has been deferred and it will become applicable across India from 15 December. So this is a prepaid rechargeable tag for toll payments. So you can see it will become mandatory for all vehicles. So this is Ministry of Road Transport and Highways decision. So this is a coverage on what FASTag actually is. It's RFID, Radio Frequency Identification Technology. Here you have. And then here the third article is, why are there objections to the transgender persons bill? So we have discussed this in news too over the week regarding the transgender persons bill which has been initiated now, and it has been passed by Lok Sabha. So the parliament has made this into a law. So it has been passed by Lok Sabha in August and by Rajya Sabha also presently. It was moved to a select committee by Lok Sabha earlier. So the demand for moving it to Rajya Sabha for demand for moving it to select committee for further discussion on the bill was rejected, and it was passed in Rajya Sabha. So what are the issues with this bill? We had seen how there is a district magistrate who would certify a person as a transgender. So questions are being raised, and the different types of identities under the trans as such. You know? So trans identities. So those are the concerns. Criminalizing their way of living are concerns. So this is a complete coverage on this. Questions raised are, does the bill address issues of gender inequality? Does it consider the appeal and concerns of the community itself? So activists say the name transgender is restrictive and shows a lack of understanding of the complexities in people who do not conform to the gender binary male-female. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first article is combination therapy using malaria drug quickly clears TB. So this was in news earlier too, that how a drug for malaria helps in fighting against TB. So this treatment has led to near complete clearance of the bacteria from the mice lungs in just 2 months. So this coverage on this. And then here you have, this is a question corner which has been initiated now. So this talks about photosynthesis, that is there less photosynthesis taking place in leaves on lower branches of a tree and in permanent shade from direct sunlight. So the answer to this question is given here. And below you have CCMB, that is Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology, a CSIR organization in Hyderabad. So CCMB team has used E. coli bacteria to study bacterial cell wall development. And the cell wall of the bacteria that has been found is made of mostly of one large molecule called peptidoglycan. So this study will help in further fight against bacteria, understanding their cell walls. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage in which important international issues from across the globe are covered. So first one is firefighters under fire for fighting Amazon blaze. So four volunteers who are fighting in the Amazon fires have been arrested on charges of starting fire. So this is an issue here, you can see. So fires in Amazon forests in Brazil had been controversial. The newly appointed government of Brazil, it was said, has actually allowed clearance of forests and fires in forests so that land can be cleared and can be used for, you know, other development and, you know, perspectives, economic perspectives. So this has become controversial now, where firefighting volunteers themselves have been accused of starting the fire. And here you have Ballads, Billionaires and Bloomberg. So this is regarding elections in USA. So the former New York mayor is now directing his own fortunes towards his presidential campaign. So presidential elections will take place in USA. So this is in that context. And this is Sri Lanka witnessing a shift in rainfall patterns. So Sri Lanka has been alternating between droughts and floods over the past few years. So this is a coverage on this issue. And this is the rise of red tourism in China. So what do you mean by red tourism? Tourism means which attracts tourists in borders to sites that showcase China's revolutionary past. So showcasing revolutionary past is helping government promote the legitimacy of the Communist Party. So that is it. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.